machine gunning mechs with jetpacks and rocket launchers. Did you ask for more? We'll find out as I review Hawken this week on The Signal. Hey guys, Signal Warden here with another episode of The Signal. This week I jumped in the cockpit and took Hawken for a ride. I love mech-based games. I've been a huge fan of the mech genre since the first Mech Warrior game back in the 80s. Let's get rid of any illusions as to what Hawken is. Hawken is a straightforward first-person shooter. Hawken is not Mech Warrior Online. That isn't a bad thing, as they're both incredible games, but the separation needs to be noted. Where Mech Warrior is extremely deep and complex, Hawken is focused on fast-paced engagements. These are not slow, lumbering mechs. You'll be rocketing around the map and jumping to different levels for vantage points and dashing away for escapes. The customization is nowhere near what you could do in Mech Warrior, but it for damn sure isn't shallow either. So that's a lot of what Hawken is not. Now let's talk about what Hawken is. First and foremost, it should be mentioned that Hawken, created by Adhesive Games and published by Meteor Entertainment, is still in beta, so things will change as time goes by. But the game as it stands is pretty fleshed out and close to the finished product. As I said, Hawken is a first-person shooter, where you pilot one of several different types of walking tanks, aka mechs. You'll start with a basic mech and earn in-game credits to purchase new classes and upgrades to modify it. There's also cosmetic upgrades that could only be purchased with real money. You can also obtain gear upgrades and new mechs with real money, but the weapons upgrades can only be used when you reach a certain level in that mech. There's also a level-based skill tree that will give you global attributes. There is a backstory to the game in which humans have colonized another planet and over-industrialized it. Now you're fighting for the remaining resources. Adhesive Games has announced that the story will be explored more with a web series and graphic novels.
The Renegade wants to save the planet. Everything is on the line for this mission.
It's kidnapping.
Yeah, she looks familiar.
They took her because she knows how to reverse the Hawken virus.
In-game, there's no story campaign, though, at least not yet, so it's pretty inconsequential. What does matter is the gameplay, and that's where Hawken really shines. This game is fast. Really fast. The HUD is awesome, and targeting feels just right. Ducking in and out of combat feels great, and team play feels very organized. A good chunk of skirmishing in Hawken is based around your thrusters. They have limited but rapidly recharging fuel supplies that will allow for you to either dash in any direction at high speed, or jet upward to ledges, or conversely, to break a long fall. There are certain maps that have very high perches, and you'll use leap pads to get to them. Being able to break line of sight or chase to keep someone in line of sight is key. The weapon system on the mechs are different, but across all of them you have two weapon slots, usually one for rapid-fire machine gun, and the other for a high-damage, low-rate secondary weapon. You'll also have the option, after certain levels, to obtain stationary offensive weapons like mines and sentry turrets. There are also emergency limited-use countermeasures and internal components that deal with things like overheating reduction. There are currently four modes of play. You have Deathmatch, which is an every-man-for-himself timed killfest. Team Deathmatch, where you work to eliminate the opposing team. Missile Assault, where you have to capture and keep certain map objectives. And Siege, where you gather energy to launch a huge ship at the enemy and man surface-to-air missiles to take their ship down. After each death, you can choose a different mech in your arsenal and go back in with it. So if you die and decide it was because your team needed a tank out front, you can come back as that tank. The HUD is laid out beautifully. It isn't as simplistic as what you saw in Armored Core 5, but there are no problems finding any info at a glance. You'll be able to identify a kill easily, and the targeting reticle does a great job of telling you when you have someone locked in your sights. The HUD takes up a bit of real estate, but only enough so that you can truly feel like you're piloting a mech, which can really add to the immersion. The controls are quick too, so you can react immediately to any situation. The world may seem a little gray to some people, but honestly, I like it, and I think it works to get the industrial feeling across with. There's never really an issue identifying enemies against the backdrop. I did lose track of allies on the minimap from time to time, though. Hawken does a so-so job of making the world look as decimated as I imagine they intended. With a bird's eye view, the feeling of desolation and devastation is immediate and intense. Trouble is, you never see the maps from that perspective. Your surroundings still look good though, and are constructed in such a way that navigation is easy and environmental conflicts are minimal. It's just that areas you move around feel cleaner than they were most likely meant to. The mechs, on the other hand, look perfect and are rugged-looking and battle-worn. Your point of view is open. Even when the settings are changed to really feel the jarring of the mech moving, you don't have a problem losing targets or your orientation. The in-game sounds are great, and the voice acting, though minimal, was well done and really adds to your sense of immersion. Modifying mechs is always fun. Knowing that every killer assist will move you towards the next modification goal feels far more effective and gratifying than playing to get the next gun or cool hat. I caught myself saying, one more match. 3 matches after I meant to shut the game down every time I played. The nature of combat in this game allows for a little more strategic thinking than you get in most running guns, which leads to going back in after every death thinking what mech you'll use, where to position, and how to engage to improve your kill score. One of the things that can sour me to shooters faster than anything is the community. This game, at least in beta form, has a pretty stellar community. In the time I was playing, I encountered zero ragers or trolls, and in one match early on where I had never played the game mode, I was gently instructed to switch mechs because the one I was using wasn't helpful to the team. Things like that go a long way in ensuring new players will in time become veteran players. Hawken had a lot of hype behind it going in. I can honestly say that it was well placed. This game is responsive, fun, and addictive. There's no feeling of frustration even when you feed, and a great sense of reward when you don't. The microtransaction system leaves a little to be desired, but it doesn't feel broken, and there isn't a foreboding sense of pay-to-win inherent in it. Hawken has a bright future in front of it, and I wouldn't be surprised to see it sitting at the top of the competitive scene in time, so long as they keep releasing compelling mechs and avoid the pay-to-win system at every possible turn. There's talk of them already having a new mech ready for release every month of 2013, and they're adding some alpha maps back in, plus spectator mode and a horde mode. There's also talk of them adding clan support. I can't really think of any negative experiences I had during the game, and as it's free to play, I suggest anyone with an affinity for mechs or shooters give it a try. Hawken is available for download on playhawken.com. So that wraps up Hawken. Before I go, I just want to announce the winner of last week's draw. Congratulations to Nick Revels. You have a copy of Blur and a few other goodies headed your way. Be sure to check out the midweek bonus video, Twitter, and Facebook to see what the next drawing will be for and how to enter. Have any thoughts about Hawken or this review? Let me know in the comments below. Be sure to like and subscribe to get weekly reviews and bonus content. Like on Facebook and follow on Twitter for updates, news, and giveaways. Check out Livestream for a schedule of when you can play along with me as I play games leading up to my reviews. I'm Signal Warden, and thanks for watching. I'll see you next week on The Signal.